Today we'll be seeing about Grbac normal form, which is referred as GNF. Grbac normal form, all the production must be of in the following form, that is A tends to small a, or A tends to small a followed by C1, C2, C up to CN. So here capital A and C1, C2 up to CN are non-terminals, or that is variables, and small letter a is a terminal symbol. So you can see the GNF is of form, either it should, right hand side should have a single terminal symbol or a single terminal symbol followed by non-terminal symbols. So that is the format of GNF, Grbac normal form. Let us see the procedure how to convert the context-free grammar into Grbac normal form. So we have four steps here. The first step is the given context-free grammar must be free of null production and unit production. Suppose if the context-free grammar has unit production or null production, we have to remove it. The second step is we have to check whether the given context-free grammar is in CNF form, that is Chomsky normal form. If the context-free grammar is not in Chomsky normal form, we have to convert it into Chomsky normal form. So in the previous video, I have told you how to remove unit production, how to remove null production, and how to convert a context-free grammar into context normal form. The next step is we have to check it is in the GNF form, Grbac form. So for that, what you do is we will change the names of all the non-terminals into some AI. So in the series of A, okay. So the I must be in ascending order. It should start from 1 to till N it can go. Then you have to convert the terms into Grbac form. Sometimes when you are trying to convert, you may encounter a recursive production. So what do you mean by recursive production? For example, I have given here capital A tends to capital A B B. So here A is getting replaced by A itself again and again, and that type of recursion is called left recursion. So you have to remove this left recursion. So how to remove it? So the left recursion following equation is ABB, that is the recursive part. Okay, left recursive part is the right hand side production ABB, which is non-recursive part is XY, and A is the non-recursive part. Now what you will do is you will create a new variable to resolve the recursion, and you will use the new variable to form the original expression. How do I make it? So in the recursive part ABB, A is the non-terminal that is creating problem. So there are the BB, which is not creating any problem, will be combined with P. So how do you write the production for the new variable is, I'm going to consider a new variable P. Okay. So in the recursive part, the non-problematic part will be written once, then it will be written along with P once. That means it will be written without P once and it will be written with P once. You can see P is the new variable. So I have written the non-problematic part in the recursive, that is BB. So P tends to BB without P, then BB with P. So with the new variable. Next, the A production will be replaced with the non-recursive part, that is X, Y and A. So that also will be written without the new variable and with the new variable. So without the new variable, it will be A tends to X, Y or A. With the new variable is X, Y of P and AP. So let us see how this is going to use, these steps are going to be used to convert a context-free grammar into GNF. We'll see the examples. So let us see an example how to convert the context-free grammar into GNF. So first we should identify what are the terminal variables and non-terminal variables. So the non-terminal variables are capital letter S, A, B and C. So and the terminal variables are A and B. So you'll see the procedure one by one. So step one, you have to check for unit production and null production. If there is unit production and null production, you have to remove it. So in given context-free grammar, there is no unit production and null production. The second step is you have to check for whether it is in CNF or not. So it is in CNF, you can see. You have only two non-terminal variable combinations with for all the production, or it will be having one terminal single. So the given CFG grammar is in CNF form. So let us go for the third step. So what we'll be seeing the GNF, that is Grbac normal form. So all the production should be in the ascending order. So it must be in ascending order. So how to check this? So first let us convert all the productions into some series. So how to do that? So you start from the first production rule. So if S tends to CA, so let us start naming each and every non-terminal with some series of names. So series of variables like S tends to A1. So in this production, I have first a non-terminal, yes. The second non-terminal is C. So you can have C is equal to A2. So you should have this orders because if you change the order, then the ascending order calculation will be different. So the third variable encountered is A, so you will have A3. So the next production is about with BB. So when you consider S tends to BB, we have already changed a new name for S. So we are encountering with a new non-terminal variable, that is B. So we will have BS A4. So we can see I have already done everything. So S tends to is done. Next one is B. So when you consider B terminal, you have a terminal variable small b and non-terminal S and B, where S and B have been already numbered. So next we go for C tends to B. So here capital C is coming for the first time. So you will have C is implies A5. Now we will rewrite the productions which are given in the form. So we'll rewrite the production such as it will be A1 instead of S, we'll use A1. So A1 goes to A2, A3, or it goes to A4, A4. Similarly, and B, production B, which will be replaced with A4. So A4 goes to either a terminal B or it goes to A1, A4. Similarly, you will turn other terminals. Next production is C production. So C production is going to be A5. A5 gives B. And finally, A production gives A, which is going to be A3. So you will be having A3 gives A. After this, so after converting this, you have to check. So the next step will be step 4 to check all the productions are having in ascending order with the correction of I. So you will be checking all the non-terminals are in ascending order of I, such that if AI tends to AJ, then is valid unless I is less than J. So you should remove the production, or you should try to replace. So replace all the productions, replace the production which has I is greater than or equal to J. So this will be your step. So you have to check all the productions. So let me show which are the productions are in the form. So you can see here it is A1, so I is 1. Here it is 2, so it is valid. So I is less than 2. Similarly, I is less than 4. So 1 is less than 2 and 1 is less than 4. So it is valid. Here 4, here it is 1. So 4 is greater than 1. So this is not in GNF form. So it is not accepted. It is not done used for GNF. Whereas these two are already in GNF. Why? GNF can have the form A tends to A, where A is the non-terminal and non-terminal and small a is the terminal. So these two are already in GNF. So we have to change only A1 and A4 alone. So the second production is not in the ascending order in terms of I. So what you will do is, we will have to replace this. So how to recorrect it is, so we will take, so A4 tends to, so instead of A1, we will substitute, instead of A1, we will substitute the production for A1. So let me write only for A1 alone first. So it will be A2, A3, then the production A4 of the term, then A4, A4, then the production of B. Okay, so I have written the B at the last. So this A2 and A4 are the productions of, sorry, again A4, then production of B. So what I have done here is, instead of A1, I have substituted the productions of A1 over here along with the A4. So now you can see whether it is in the ascending order. So if you consider this one, A4, still it is not in the ascending order. So here we have used A1 production. So I will write it in this form, right? Now you can see here, still A2 is not in the form, okay? So we will try to replace A2. So what is A2 is? A2 is B. So when you try to replace, it will become, so A4 tends to B, A3, A4, then A4, 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 or B, okay? So finally, we will rewrite this. So I will rewrite this term into two terms. Why? I will tell you. So finally, I will rewrite B or B, A3, A4, or A4, A4, and A4. So in this A4 production, now you can see B is in GNF, and any GNF, it has to start with the terminal symbols followed by non-terminal symbols of series. So this is also in GNF, but this one is not in GNF. So you can see it is a left recursion. A4 tends to A444. So it is an left recursion. So the next step we are going to do here is, we are going to remove the left recursion. So we will remove left recursion. So here we will divide the terms. First, the left recursion alone, that is, if it is A4 tends to A4, A4, and A4. So the problematic here is this A4. So the remaining term, you can use a new variable to replace. So how do I do that? So I will replace that as P tends to A4, A4, then followed by again A4, A4P. So if you see the rule, it is going to be of this form only. So if you have any form, the second term must be given as it is, and it must be followed with P. So this is one rule. So we have removed the left recursion with the A4. Now what will be the A4 production? So the A4 production without recursion will be B of B, A3, A4. So the remaining terms, it must be written with the combination of P. So what do you do with the retaining with the combination is? So this term will be written as it is. Then it will be written along with P. So what happens is, when I am writing with along with P, so you can see it will be like this. So you will have BP and BA3, A4, P. Now you can see A4 is having a single terminal symbol, or starting symbol is a terminal symbol in all the productions. Hence A4 is in the GNF form. So let me explain the removal of left recursion again. So you will be having the remaining terms. So this is a recursion creating term, and this B and B, A3, A4 is a non-recursive form. So how to do that is, these two productions will be separated separately. It will be asked to be replaced separately with the two different productions. So what I do is, the recursion equation is being removed with a new terminal variable P. So I am using a new terminal variable P here. So the only A4 is creating recursion. The following A4 does not create any recursion. So what you'll do is, you will write this to A4 once with the new variable and once without the new variable. So what I did is, I have written with once with a new variable, that is P, and without production. So the remaining term, that is also written once with the new variable and without the new variable. So this is how you will be removing the left recursion. So here you can see it is removed without new variable, and here is also without new variable, where other term again is been written with the new variable. Now you can see A4 is in the form of a production role. Okay, so what you will try to do here is the updated production rule will be, we'll write it again. So this will be A1 tends to, okay. We have resolved only A4 alone. So A1 will be same, A2, A3, or A4. Okay, one sec. And A4 will be, so A4 we have found it, it is in grievance form, so it is B or BA3 A4 or BP or BA3 A4 P, and the remaining two terms which are A2 and A3, so we will write it. So before that we will write P, so P tends to A4 A4 and A4 A4 P, right? Then you will have A2 production, so A2 production is B and A3 production is in A. Now you can see these two are in GNF and A4 is also in GNF. So now let us consider the which are not in GNF. So you can see the GNF rule is the production must start with a terminal symbol or it must have a single terminal. So this A1 is not in BNF, where this one everything is single BNF, it's a single terminal, where others are starting with a terminal symbol, so hence it is valid. So these two are in GNF and this production is not in valid. So now to bring it to convert to GNF, we will try to replace the productions with the term. So let me take first A1 tends to A2, A3 or A4, A4. So let us use, so first I am going to substitute, instead of A2, I am going to use A2 production value. So I will use A2. So when you use A2, what is A2? So A2 is here, this is A2 and this is A3. Okay. So what is A2 is? A2 will be B. So when you replace it, you will have B, A3 and A4, A4. So this is A1. Now you can see this is in GNF, where A4, A4 is not in GNF. So what you will do is we will substitute the production of A4, use A4 production, and we will substitute the production with this term alone. So when you substitute for the production, so we will have the same term BA3 again. Now instead of A4, we will have to substitute the entire term here. So when you substitute it, it is going to be first one is B, so followed by A4. Then the production of A4 is BA3 A4, followed by again a production A4, then BP A4, then finally you have BA3 A4P, which is followed by A4. Now you can see A1 production is in a form of GNF, it is starting with term. So you will put a box over here so that we will understand that A1 is being converted into GNF. So now we'll go for the second production, which is not in GNF, that is P. P tends to A4, A4 and A4, A4P, right? So what you are going to do is we are going to use A4 production and we will try to replace in the right hand side of the production for both the A4 simultaneously. So first we'll write P tends to B, okay, that is the first production of A4, followed by you will have another term, that is A4. So you will have A4 will be combining with all the productions of A4. Followed by BA3, A4, again A4, then BP, A4, then finally BA3, A4, PA4. Now this we have done. Now for the second production, that is A4, 4P, the same thing will be done. So P, A4, P, followed by BA3, A4, this is the second production of A4. Followed by the remaining non-terminals A4P, then again followed by BP, A4P, then finally BA3, the last production. So BA3, A4P, followed by A4P. So followed by A4P. Now you can see The P production is all or replaced with the terms of first term is a terminal symbol, so we will take this one as a our P production. So the final production will be of this form. So I have just combined all the values. So this is A1 and this is a P production. So A4 and A2 and A3 are in production form. So you can see all the productions are starting with the terminal symbols, or it will be ending with a single terminal symbol. So hence the given CGF is converted into GNF. So if you want, you can finish the answer in this way, or you have to replace what is A1 and A3. So let me show that. So let us see how to rewrite the final production into the original form. So initially in the first step, in this you can see we have converted S into A1, A2, A3 and A4. So with that we have transformed the production into this form. Now we are going to reverse the process. Instead of A1, A2, A3, we are going to replace with the non-terminal variables S, C, A and B. So after replacing A1, A2, A3 with their non-terminal correspond respective non-terminal variables, so this will be your final answer. So you can see it is in GNF. So this is the GNF for the given context-free grammar. So let us see the next example. So here the non-terminal variables are S, X, Y, Z and W, and the terminal variables are A, B, C. So from the context-free grammar, we are sure that we don't have no unit production or null production, and you can see all the right hand side productions are either two non-terminals or a single terminal symbol, hence it is in context free, that is it is in CNF, okay, Chomsky normal form. So given CGF is in Chomsky normal form. If it is not in Chomsky normal form, you have to convert into Chomsky normal form. Next thing is we have to find out whether it is in GNF. For that, first we have to convert all the non-terminal variables into some series of variable. So how do I convert it? So let me convert. So we'll take first S tends to XY. So with this, we'll say S tends to A1, X tends to A2. So you have to take it only in this order. Otherwise, you will get confused. So the next production is S tends to XW. So here S and X are already done. Only W is pending. So you'll have W as A4. Then you'll take X tends to YZ. So you can see X and Y is already done. Only Z is there. So Z is tends to A5. So you can see all the terminals have been numbered into A1, A2, A3 and A4. Now we will rewrite the equation, or we will rewrite the production rule. So the production rule is rewritten as A1 tends to A2, A3. Or A2, A4. Okay, the next one is A2 tends to A3, A5 or A. Then finally, the next one is that A5? So A5 tends to C. And what is Y? Is Y is A3? So A3 tends to A4 and A5 or B. Then finally, you can see A4. It is going to tends to D. So now we will see the left hand side and right hand side are in the form of ascending order. So we will check with the first form. It is 1 here, 2, 3. So it's in ascending form. Here it is 2, 3. So it is valid. It is in ascending order. Here 2 and here 3. It is also in ascending order. So it's a terminal. So it is in GNF. So this is in GNF form. Similarly, A4 is also in GNF form. Right, and here A3 and here A4, it is also valid. So now only for A1, A2 and A3, they are not in the form of GNF. So here this production and this productions are not in GNF, whereas A is in GNF. So A is in GNF. So only A3, A5 is not in GNF. Similarly, B is in GNF. So in A1, both the productions are not in GNF format, and A2, the first production is not in GNF format, and similarly A3 also the first production is not in the product. So we'll try to convert into GNF. So we'll convert into GNF. So what you'll do is you'll take first A1 production. So A1 tends to A2, A3 and A2, A4. So the here is the first leftmost non-terminal should be replaced using the A2 production. So use A2 production to replace. So I'm using A2 production. So when you replace, it implies, so A1 is equal to, what is A2 is A3, A5. Okay. So first production is A3, A5 combined with A3. So you will have A3. The second production for A2 is A, then again combined with. So this alone will be replaced. The remaining time has to combine. So you will have A3. Now the first production of A1 is done. We'll do for the second production. Similarly for A2, it will be A3, A5 and A4. And the last production is you have A. So it will be A, A4. Now you can see in this production, again, this is valid and the last term is also valid, but this term is not valid. Okay, so this term and this term are not in GNF. So only for this production, we will try to replace using the A3 production because the first term is A3. So we'll try to replace only A3 alone. So you are going to use A3 production. The remaining productions are going to be the same. So we'll write it here. So I have substituted the A3 productions, that is two production A4, A5 and B with the first term. So you can see what is written in green color is for the production of A3, which is combined with the A5 and A3. Okay. So here you can see it is in A3 and A5. Now, which are all not in GNF. So you can see here, this term is still not in GNF format, whereas other two terms are in GNF format. So what you are going to do is we are going to use A4 production to replace these things. So let us see what is A4 is. A4 is D. So when you replace, A1 tends to D, A5, A5, A3, followed by the remaining terms. So A5, A3, A, A3. So I am breaking into two rules. So just for continuing, okay, for our understanding. So again here, instead of A4, we'll be substituting D alone. So you substitute D, again, A5, A5, A4, then finally B tends to A5, A4, and A4. So now this is in GNF form. You can see all the productions are starting from, all the productions are starting from the non, with the terminal symbols followed by non-terminal. Now, what is the only production is left over other productions? It is going to be A2 and A3. So now this is the second term, which is not in GCNF. You can see in the previous slide. So the second term is A2, A3, A5 is not in GNF, but A is in GNF. So we are going to change that. So we are going to use A3 production to replace this. Okay, so we'll be using A3 production. So now I have replaced A4, A5 with the production. You can see what is the A3 production is. A3 production is A4, A5 or B. So I have substituted A4, A5 with A5. Then again with the A, it has to be, with B, it has to be substituted. So instead of A3, I am substituting A4, A5 and B. So A5 is just continuous, so no change in A. Now you are going to use A4 production. So A4 production is A4 tends to D. Okay, A4 tends to D, we'll see here. Okay, A4 tends to D. So when you replace it, A2 tends to D, A5, A5, followed by B, A5, A. Why, sir? Because this is the only term that is not in GNF, where other terms are in GNF. So now this is the production of A2. So what is the next term we have to convert, which is A3. So A3 will be, we are going to convert it. So the next thing is A3 tends to A4, A5 or B. So use A4 production over here. So when you substitute A4 production, it is going to be A3 tends to D, A5 bar B. Okay, or the production B. Now you can see all the productions which are not in A1, A2, A3. So A1 is made clear here. A2 is made here and A3 is made here. So your final production rule P will be of, so A tends to A3, B A5 A3, then D A55, you have A55 A3, then you will have A A4 and B A5 A4, followed by D A55 and A4. Then finally you will have A2, so A2 is given over here, it is D A5 A5 or B A5 or A, and your A3 A5 will be of C, then A3 will be of D A5 or B, and finally A4 will be D. Right, so this is your final answer. So it's everything is in GNF. So if you want to have with the original non-terminal variables, you can convert it. So I have replaced all the terms into this. So we know that it is S tends to A1. So A1, A2, A3 and A4, A5 are replaced. So X tends to A2, Y tends to A3 and W tends to A4 and Z tends to A5. So which will be replaced. So this is your final answer, which is in GNF. You can see all the productions are starting with the terminal symbols, or it will have a single terminal symbol. So you can see everything are starting from terminal symbol followed by non-terminals, similarly C, D and everything. Okay, so it is the GNF, Grybak normal form for the given context-free grammar. So let us see the next example. So here again the variables, non-terminals are going to be S, X, Y, W and Z, and terminals are going to be A, B, C, D. So we can see it is in context-free, it is a context-free grammar with no unit production or null production, and you can see it is also in Chomsky normal form. So now we have to check only all the productions are in ascending order or not. So first we will convert all the non-terminals into serial variables. So let me take first production. So because why I am using first production is in this order only the variable name should be done. So S is the starting symbol and the first production is XY. So you will have S tends to A1, X tends to A2 and Y tends to A3. So still W and Z is pending. So you can see what is the next production for S is S tends to XW. So W will be A4. And then next production is X. So X tends to YZ. So X and Y are already done. So Z is going to be A5. Okay. So now we will replace all the non-terminals with the serial variables. So if you write it, so your production rule will be, it is going to be A1. A1 tends to A2 or A3, or the second production is A2, A4. Then your X2 is A2. A2 is going to be either A3, A5 or A. Then similarly A5, which is going to be a terminal symbol, and your Y is going to be A3, which goes to A2 and A5 or B. Then finally A4 tends to D. So now which are in GNF form, that we will see. So you can see this is in GNF form because it is having only one terminal symbol. So this is in GNF form. Similarly, A alone is in GNF form. And similarly here, B alone is in GNF form. Which are not in BNF form, so others are not in BNF form. Now let us check the ascending order property. So here, 1 is less than 2 and 1 is less than 2. So it is in ascending order. Here 2 is less than 3, that is I am telling about A2 and A3, A1 and A2, okay. So 2 is less than 3, so it is also in ascending order. A3, A2 is where this is not in the ascending order. So what I have to do here is I have to replace. So let me replace everything with a form. So what I will do is first I will resolve this one. So resolving the ascending order property. Ascending order for A3 tends to A2, A5 or B. So this will be replaced as using the production of A2, you'll try to replace. So when you replace it, so it will be A3, okay? So it is going to be A3, A5, you'll take first A term, then you will followed by A3, A5, followed by A5, okay? So then again you will have B alone, so it will be followed by B. So it will be followed by, sorry, not B, terminal symbol A. So this is A3. Now you have to check whether it is in ascending order or something. So this is in GNF form. Okay, so you have it in GNF, and this A is also in GNF, but A3, A55 is a left regression. You can see you have left hand side is also A, in the right hand side first symbol is also A, so it is an left regression. You have to remove the left regression. So I will write it here, the left regression is A3 tends to A3, A5, A5. So this is the production that is creating left regression. So I have to replace this A3. So how to remove left regression? We have seen the formula. So let me see, show it in the next slide, new slide. So we are going to remove the left regression. So I've written here. Now this is a regressive part, this is a non-regressive part. So how to remove the left regression? So the regressive part should be replaced with a new variable. So let me take the new variable. So the problematic non-terminal is A3, where other should be used with a new variable. So how to write it in the form is, a new variable P tends to, has to be written without the new variable and with new variable. So A5 without P, then A5 with P. Now the non-recursive part of the A3 should be written with P and without P. So we will rewrite A3. So A5 or B, or A5 P and B. So this is with P and this is without P. Here A5 without P and with P. So now the check, the regression is been removed. So A3 regression is been removed over here. Now you can see A3 is in GNF. All the terms are starting with terminal symbols. Hence A3 is in GNF. So you can have this as GNF form. Right. Similarly, you can see when P is here, again, when you check, we'll try to resolve over here is. So we'll try to resolve here. So phi, which is not in GNF. So we'll try to resolve P here itself to convert into PNF. So what I'm going to do is, instead of A5, so in the first term A5, I'm going to replace the term. Okay. So I'm going to replace the term. So I'm going to convert P into GNF. So I'm converting P into GNF. So P will be A5. A5 will be replaced with A5 productions. Similarly, here in the second production also, A5 will be replaced with the second production. So what is A5 is? So A5 is C. So your P will be replaced with C A5 P. Okay, now this is in GNF. So how did we do using A5 production? Okay, using A5 production. So let us write the production rule. So P will be A1 tends to A2, A3 or A4, sorry, A2, A4. Then A2 tends to A3, A5 or A, and A5 tends to C. Now A3 is replaced with these two terms. So we'll write this. So A3 tends to A5 or B or A5 P BP. Okay. Then you have a new variable production include with the grammar. So this is 3. So P tends to CA5 and CA5 P. And the last one is A4. so don't forget any protection. So this, now here in this, which are not in DNF form, so we will see A1 protection is not in GNF form. Similarly, A2 with the first protection, it is not in GNF, where all others are in GNF form. So let us convert into GNF. So let me convert A1 into GNF. So A1 tends to A2, A3. Okay, you will have R part. Okay, so I'll write it afterwards. So I am going to replace using A2 here. So what is A2? A2 will be A3, A5, followed by A4. So I'm going to replace the production of A2. So the A2 non-terminal will be replaced with the right hand side of the A2 production. So I have replaced wherever I had A2, I have replaced with A2 production's right hand side. You can see the green color in the first production is from A2 production. So A2 is having A3, A5 or A. So I have A3, A5 and A, which is combined with A3. Similarly, the second part of the A1 production, A2 is replaced with the right hand side of A3. So I have written in orange color A3, A5 followed by A4 and small a, A4. Now you can see which are not in GNF. You can see the second term and the last term are in GNF. So the term which are not here is A3, A5, A4 and A3, A5, A4. So the remaining terms are same. So here in both the term, I am going to try to replace A3. So what is A3 is, this is the term fully that is for A3. So I am going to replace this entire term with A3. So now you can see the first term A3, A5, A3. A3 is alone replaced with the red color or the using the production of right hand side of A3. I have replaced, and the remaining A5 and A3 is combined with all the right hand side production of A3. You can see here, this is A3 productions which are in red color and black colors. So I have just combined A5 and A3. So the remaining terms have been written as it is, which is AA3 and AA4 are written over here. So you can see all the productions are starting from starting with the terminal symbols in the right hand side. Hence A1 production is in GNF. Now we have to go for the second term, A2, A3, A5. Similarly, here instead of A3, you have to substitute A3 production. So now we will see how to convert this. So you are going to use A3 production's right hand side. So you'll use A3 production right hand side. So what is A3 production right hand side is? You can see it is AA5B, AA5BPP. Okay, so that we will try to replace here. So I have replaced A3 production with the A2 production, substituting instead of A3, I have substituted A3 productions along with A5. You can see A5 is repeated in everywhere. The last term is again A5 and then finally it is A. Now you can see A2 is also in GNF form. So what is the only any other term to be converted? No, only A1 and A2. So your final production rule, P can be written as, okay, let me check once. So what is P? Okay, here A1 is updated. So you'll write A1 in two terms. So because of the length, okay, so you'll have A5 A3 or B A5 A3 or A A5 P A5 A3 or BPA5A3 or AA3. So let me finish. So we have written everything. So this is the GNF for the given context free grammar, GRIMEC normal form for the GRIBEC normal form for the given context free grammar. So if you want, you can replace A1, A2, A3 with the non terminals X, X, and Y. So I will leave it to your end. So let us see a next example. So now we'll see this example a little faster. You can see S tends to AA and A tends to SS. So you have a recursion over here. So let us take first, S is the start symbol. So we'll remove the recursion or we'll try to resolve it lastly. So first we'll take A. A tends to SS or 1. So let me use S production over here. So use the S production. Okay, so when you substitute it, A tends to, I can substitute it for the first S only, not like any combination. So you will have AAS or AA1. Okay, so you'll have, sorry, it is 0, no? Okay, not 0. Or it is 0S or it is 1. So now you can see the second term and the last two terms are in GNF form, where this is having a left recursion. So I have to remove the left recursion. So how to remove that? So to remove the left recursion, we have to consider the recursive part and the non-recursive part. So AAS is the recursive part, and 0, 1, -1 is the non-recursive part. So how do we write it? So you will have a new variable to convert that. So I will take it as P. So P tends to, I will take, this is the term that is creating recursion. So rest of the term should be considered. It has to be written with P and without P once. So without P once and with P once. Now the non-recursive part should be written as it is and with P once. So you'll have your A2 production, sorry, A production. So your A production will be 0S or 1 with 0S P, 1P. Okay. Now you can see A is in Grbac form. Okay. So it is in Grbac form. So it is in GNF. So only thing is P is not in Grbac form. So let me bring P2 over here. So to make P tends to AS and A tends to SP in Grbac form. So that is in GNF. So what I'm going to do here is, instead of A, I'm going to substitute the production over here, A production value over here. So when I do it, so P tends to, so instead of A, I have used the right hand side of A to replace in P. Now the P will be having, so the first line represents the first production AS. Instead of A, I have written in green ink O. So S will be retaining in all the expression, and similarly P will be retaining. Now if you see, P is also in, it is also in the Grbac form. Okay, so it is in GNF form, right? So finally, when you substitute, what is S? S is going to be AA. So that is not still in, so S tends to AA. So S tends to AA or 0, still this is not in Grbac form. So instead of A, I will substitute. So how do I substitute? What is A is 0S. So 0S followed by A, 1A, 0SPA, then 1PA followed by 0. So now S is also in Grbac form. So your final production rule is, your final production rule is S tends to 0SA or 1A or 0SPA or 1PA or 0. Similarly, your A production is going to be of 0S or 1 or 0SP or 1P. Similarly, your new term variable P is going to be 0SS or 1S or 0SPS or 1PS or 0SSP or 1SP. So I don't have a space, so let me write it again. P tends to OSPSP or 1PSP. So this is of GNF form for the given context-free grammar. So you see the last example of GNF. So this is going to be terminal variables are AB and non-terminal variables are A1, A2 and A3. So we know that there is no unit production, there is no null production, and since it is a CNF, you won't have it. So you'll see which are in ascending order, which are not in ascending order directly. So you can see here the first production is in ascending order, the second production A2, A3, it is also in ascending order. So here it is also. Now A3 and A1 is not in ascending order, so we'll start from that one. So A3 tends to A1, A2 or A. So instead of A1, we'll substitute A1 production. So when you substitute A1 production, it is going to be A2, A3, A2 or A. Now still you can substitute what is A2 over here. right? So A2 will be substituted as, with using A2 production, so we'll substitute A3 A1 followed by A3 A2, or B A3 A2, or A. So now you can see still this term and this term are in GNF, where this term is not in GNF. So as well as you can see, it is A3, this is A3. So this term is a left regression. So you have to remove the left regression. So how it is left regression? You can see the first term and the first terms are similar. So it is left regression. So you have to remove the left regression equation here. So let me remove the left regression. So I'm going to remove it, remove the left regression. So let me write the regressive part first. So A3 tends to A3, A1, A3, A2. So this term is regressive. Okay, and the non-regressive part, I will write it in a different term. Okay, I will write it in green color. So the non-regressive part is B, A3, A2, or A. So the regressive part, you have to create a new variable and write the remaining terms with P and without P. So with new variable and without new variable. So A1, A3, A2, without P and with P, A3, A2, P. Okay. Similarly, A3 will be modified. That is, you have to take the non-regressive part. You have to write it once without P and once with P. So let me write it as B A3 A2 or A followed by B A3 A2 P and A P. So this, you can see A3 is now in GNF form. It is starting with a terminal symbol in all its production. So it is in GNF. So you don't need to change anything over here, right? So similarly, we'll before going to P, okay? So if you want to go to P, we want to know A1, so it will be a regression. So let me first complete the other terms here. So what is the other terms that should be replaced? Let us consider first. So you have, you'll write the production rule first. So you have A1 tends to A2, A3, then A2 tends to A3, A1, or A. Now A3 is converted into B, A3, A2, or A, or B, A3, A2, P, or A, P. Then finally, you are included with a new production rule, P, which is going to be A1, A3, A2, or A1, A3, A2, P. Now in this, which are not in GNF form, that is Grbac form, is, you will see the first term, it is not in Grbac form. The second term, A2, is also, production is also not in Grbac form. And P, it is also having, both the terms are not in Grbac form. So we'll solve it one by one. So first let me take with A1. So A1 tends to A2, A3. Okay, so you have A2 and A3. So A1 has A2, no? Right. So let me check first. So A1 needs A2, A2 needs A3. So first we'll take A3. So that will be easier for us to solve. So A2 tends to A3 because A3 is in GNF form. So now instead of A3, we have to substitute A3 production. So which is the production? So this is the production we have to use, A3. So we'll substitute. So after substitution of A3 production, A2 is in GNF form. You can see it starts with B, A, B, A, and B. So A2 is in GNF. So the next production we'll be seeing is A1. A1 goes to A2, A3. Okay, so A1 goes to A3. So we will try to replace A2 production with this. So use A2 production over here. So we'll write A1 tends to, with the productions of A2. So you can see the red colors are the productions from A2. The remaining term in the right hand side of the A1 is written in black. So you can see A3 is repeated with all the productions of A2. Now finally, we'll go for production P. So P tends to A1, A2, A, sorry, it is A3, right? It is A3, A2, and A1, A3, A2, P. So now what we are going to do is we are going to use the production A1 over here. So use A1 production. Okay. So all the A1 production is going to be written along with A3, A2 and A3, A2, P. So I have replaced the A1 production with its right hand side in for the production P. So you can see the red color returns are the right hand side production of A1, and green and blue color terms are the combined the terms with the A production, so which is written. So you can see P production, A production, A2 production and A3 productions are in GNF. So you'll have this 1, 2 and 3, all the four productions are in GNF. You can see I had only 1, 2, 3, 4 productions. So 1, 2 and 3 and 4, now all the four productions are in GNF form, hence the context free grammar is converted into a GNF format. Thank you. We will meet with a new topic in the next session.